So moving ahead, after the judgment of Balaji, we come to the year of 1964. So in 1964, the case is Devadasan versus Union of India. Now this particular case is limited to only two things. One is it relates to the reservation in favor of SCs and STs only. We will not discuss the backward classes in this very case. Number two, it relates only to a specific rule which is known as the carry forward rule. Now this may be one of the cases which started allegedly the politics of not found suitable, which is popularly known as NFS. Why? Now this rule was challenged under Devadasan versus Union of India. So the fact was, please look at the case, that it related to the validity of carry forward rule obtaining in Central Secretariat Service. The reservation in favor of scheduled caste was 12%, while reservation in favor of scheduled tribes was 5%. So the rule was this, which is given here. Now according to the rule, I'll explain this. So if there are 30 vacancies in a particular year, for example, 10 are reserved seats and 20 are open category seats. And if these 10 seats are not filled in this particular year, for example, only 5 were filled. So this will be carried forward in the second year. So for example, next year there is fresh allocation of 30 seats. So 5 of this seat will be added to the fresh release of seats. So total will be 35, in which 10 will be reserved fresh and 5 will be reserved which are carried forward. So the reservation will be now 15 and 20. Now further, if for example 13 seats were not filled from the people belonging to the SCs and STs, so now these 13 seats will then be carried forward. So if there is a fresh allocation of 30 seats again, so 20 will be open, plus 10 will be reserved, plus 13 will be carried forward. So 20 will be fresh seats for open category, and 23 will be the seats for reserved category. Now if you apply the decision of Balaji, that at no instance reservation shall exceed the 50% of the seats barrier. So carrying forward of the seats each particular year, adding it to the next year, resulted in the breach of the rule given by Balaji. Now one additional point to be remembered is that if 5 of the seats were not filled from the reserved category, these 5 seats were changed into unreserved category. So it was not that people were not selected, people were selected, but reserved category people were not selected, being termed as not found suitable. So therefore you see in the rule that if a sufficient number of candidates considered suitable by recruiting authorities are not available from the communities from whom reservations are made in a particular year, the unfilled, so this is the unfilled, that is the 5 seats, unfilled vacancies should be treated as unreserved. So these 5 vacancies will then shift to this 20 seats. and filled by best available candidates. So in this particular year also, all the seats are filled. So 25 from open category and 5 from the reserved category. The number of reserved vacancies thus treated as unreserved will be added as an additional quota to the number that would be reserved in the following year. So these 5 seats will then be added to the second year of allotment. So now it will become 15. For example, for these seats, only 2 were found suitable. Rest of the 13 were not found suitable. So this 13 will get added to this 20. And 33 people will be selected from open category. But this value 13 will then be added to the next year. Now, if this is added to the next year, it then breaches the 50% rule. Therefore, in this case, what happened that out of 45 appointments made, 29 went to scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. Now, therefore, in other words, the extent of reservation in the third year came to 65%. Now, the rule was declared unconstitutional because the majority held that the carry forward rule, which resulted in more than 50% of the vacancies being reserved, is bad because Balaji has stated that the 50% rule shall be followed. In this very case, Justice Subba Rao dissented, and the very famous opinion of the legislative device came up. So what is a legislative device? So according to Justice Subba Rao, nothing in this article, which is mentioned in 16.4 and 15.4, is not to be treated as an exception, but as a legislative device. This legislative device is a power which the state is conferred by the constitution. Now, this power is untrammeled. It is not limited by any the other provision of the article. So 16.4 or 15.4 is a legislative device and is not limited to 15, limited by 15.1, or is restricted by 15 or 16.1. Now, this was a dissenting opinion, but the court accepted the rule of Balaji, which said it is 50% only to be allowed, and in Balaji it was said that 15.4 is an exception to 15.1. Now, one additional point I would like you to note is a point for adequacy of representation. So 16.4 requires that a class has to be backward, and in the opinion of the state, it shall not be adequately represented. Then only 16.4 will be applied in favor of reservation. Now, the court said that it is not the matter of the court to decide whether any backward class is adequately represented or not. It is the subjective satisfaction of the state.